All good. You right? You're going to do your commando roll. You're going to do your commando roll.
I tried to. I fucking stay on
the roof. Get it up. Get it up. Get your center of gravity up. Push the. Keep pushing the bike up.
Mate.
Keep pushing your bike vertical. That's it. Put your front brake on if you can, anyway. So I, oh, it, when you first start off, you know, for the first few, you know, 10, 15 minutes, it's always like this, though. I'll show you something. If your bike's over,
yeah.
Right. I notice when you try to lift it up like this. Lift from one bar only. Oop. Yeah, it's actually easier. Oh, more so on the other side because you can grab your brake, but it's actually easier to lift with one bar, believe it or not.
Yeah,
no. Just lift against that.
Well, it's got fuel.
On that.
Yeah. Must have come out a bit.
Yeah. Is that injected?
Fuck, I couldn't even tell you.
Oh, okay.
You presume it's 2014.
Yeah. Well, if I get close enough, you'll see a float bowl on. If it's carby. Well, this is injected. It's got no carby bowl on it. Oh, continue. Your squeaks as well, does it?
What?
Yeah. fair enough. It's either I'm going to go through or I'm going to fall off, one of the two.
Exactly.
You're saying about the height of your bike. I think it's okay.
I reckon it is. I was in it last night. I was like...
Remember how this bike was, when I came out with you the first time, the bike was, you know, not running properly, stalling and carrying on?
Because you played with the fucking idle.
No, it was a battery.
Bullshit.
Battery was fucked in it. Put a new battery in it, but it's gold.
I was fucking get a drink of water, man.
Sure.
Heart's ready. This fucking... Not disheartening, but fucking...
Yeah, I'll just get a drink of water.
You know, like, fucking first 2 minutes in, I was fucking off twice. You're like, fucking hell.
It's a psychological thing too,
isn't it?
Man. From that point on, for the next few minutes or 5 minutes.
I reckon those last two hills, anyway. I've hit them better. The first fucking 10 minutes than what I did all of last time.
Except when you fell over.
This is shit. Look at that big mouthful before we left. Straight up, fucking not cold at all now, eh?
No, it's perfect. Yeah, but having for me, when I dropped from the 450s, I was concerned about the power loss. But when I first turned off the distance, I was like, fucking hell no. And the maneuverability of this thing, if I do get it outside. Yeah, but just then when I sort of stopped there, it's like, yeah, okay, I only need to roll back now a foot and I can sit. Just go again.
Yeah, as soon as I looked where you went, I was just like, yeah. Like, nah, go beside the tree, like, got a little stump there.
It just seemed like it was a case of, well, I'm either going to make it or fall over,
yeah.
And just, blah.
No, I reckon, the old mate told me, oh, what was up, he's like, he was in second. No, I just went staying first, man.
Yeah. No, because, it's the same thing, even the most, depending on the length and so forth, but most of my hills are in first here as well.
If it starts to tug, that's where I lose pace, and I think, fucking.
Second gear is fine when you've got a bit of speed and momentum.
When it's a smooth hill, but not when you're fucking negating fucking ruts and shit.
Correct, yeah. That only comes with skill. I mean, you see some of it. Yeah, that'll do. And also, when you, say if you're in second or even third gear, and you've got power applied.
Yeah.
Even this thing will do it. It's been third gear up there. As long as I've got the throttle around.
Yeah. You take it off and it'll...
Yeah, but as soon as you lose ground speed, if you're in something third doing that. But, yeah, that would be...
So, downhill's still careful, I think.
Oh, okay.
Absolutely. That's where you see me taking it so easy,
yeah,
man.
That's cool. Cool. Funny, in the first 3 minutes, the brakes have actually... Because I put the brakes in, just let it sit in the back. So...
Just haven't looked at
them. Oh. They've bedded in nicely already. Still having good brakes.
You do that stuff yourself, yeah?
I don't know. 2 minutes?
Oh, really?
Just two center pins. What do you call them? Like a circlet type of...
Yeah, thing. I know what you're talking about.
And the pin just drops out and they just drop straight out. When you run in.
Yeah. Cotter pin?
Yeah, there's like a cotter pin with two safety clips in it.
You don't center it? You pull the brake on and it just does it?
Yeah, just pump it maybe five times. They pull up. That's it. We can, when you get back to the cars, you can trip on mushrooms for a few hours if you want to. Then.
I reckon there would be some around here.
More so Dalesford. I mean, we're sort of close to Dalesford, but yeah. they're either going to just be standard mushrooms or ones that'll kill you. I don't know. There's no golden. I haven't seen any golden tops.
Oh, we mean it, maybe, man.
Yeah.
I suppose Victoria is a different house plus gold top.
Yeah, well, they put a warning out early because there's been high humidity weather recently.
Yep.
They put a warning on the, it was on the Age newspaper in the health and finance section. You know, for those who had in brackets, you know, do collect mushrooms for whatever reason, be aware that of the, what do they call it, the deadly?
Oh, I know what you call them, man.
Do you need a piss? Do you need a piss?
Yeah, I do a little bit.
Piss, dude.
No, you're right.
If it's not comfortable. We're not under any time constraints. Alright. See if it'll go with a kick.
Thank you.
you do this last time?
It's when I
sat down. Okay, so you did get up though, yeah?
No. You rode it back down and rode it up.
So I think it's
the far side. We went up this side last time.
Yeah, we did. I think this one might be slightly, I think.
How deep is that paddle?
The paddle, right there? Oh.
Ah,
just go, just chug, just idle through. It's only that deep.
That's our book.
Hey. For me, it doesn't make much of a difference, really. But it's something you have to hit with a bit of speed.
How do you feel about riding two blocks up?
Yeah, that's cool. There's this funny, depending on who's on the ride, there's a chick called Dirt Girly.
Yeah.
And she's, you know, typical, very, very Aussie. And, we'd stumble across like this, and some of the low-grade rides, you know, she'd say, oh, would some of mine ride me bike up? You realise what the penalty is? And she goes, yeah. It's a blowjob for Hill. But yeah, it's not
good. It's good to have a chick that can fucking laugh for
it. Yeah. Yeah, see, for me, I just chug straight up the centre there. Well, like,
oh, yeah?
Yeah.
If I was going to do it, I would probably go the right end side of the left trail. Yeah, just that small little fucking clue, it's like, I suppose that's going to kick you like a start-o.
Yeah. Fucking battery, fucking shit, mate. Well, that first route's going to either throw me off.
Either up down the right hand side, so there's only that one.
See what happens? I won't sit there and burn much more energy on this, I'll just turn around and go down and come back up the other way. But it is
worth doing that.
No, I'll just drop it down and turn around. It's actually quite much under.
Fucking hope it is, I can't believe it.
Yeah.
It is that crazy as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you had a bit of trouble going through that, then I would have had no chance.
Yeah, especially now if you get to hear them still chewed up. Yeah, but when you're on a hill, get your bike back to its vertical point where you're not burning energy holding it.
I think that's where I waste most of my energy, man. It's just trying to fucking manhandle it out of spots.
Hmm. Yeah, and yeah, and the whole thing about sitting there, say, like this going, no, it's not going to fucking do anything.
All I could think about is tearing off a knob, man. It's the last thing I want.
Oh, well. But you can see I was trying to just roll back, say, a foot.
Yeah.
And then launch it. And so I'm sort of used to the point where the bike's up, but it won't go over.
Yeah, I was only trying to take your ass off the seat and shit.
Yeah, just to get it over this hump here, but I didn't. I got a couple of videos of me on the first or second ride launching this thing.
Just fucking
ghosty.
Yeah. So what, having proper boots makes a lot of difference, man.
The boots. Yeah.
Why don't you go for it from there?
Nah.
Up there?
Yeah, well.
Do you want to pick the front tire up, put it there?
No, it'll still put me on an angle. Mm. It'll just drop into that. Yeah, I mean, suddenly when you look at it, it doesn't look like much, but...
Off camber as well.
Yeah. No, I'll just drop down. Try to.
Right?
Yep.
This way probably looks a bit easier, man.
Yeah, yeah. So when you're on the hill too, like, I just turned around then, first thing, brake, and I can sit here like this all day.
It's easier, I'll feather me back, if the back comes off, I'm ready to go on the front, take its place.
And things like that can hurt too. Yeah.
No, this still scares me, man.
It's funny, walking up and down hills.
Harder than riding a bike.
doing that as easy as possible. Difficult walking in boots too, especially ones that don't bend. It's got noticeably more grunt, just with the clutch out, does it?
Yeah.
Your clutch is grabbing. I don't know how you ride. I tend to wrap with these.
I'll go three, man.
Three.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, but it's grabbing just here. I personally think you should have it out a little bit further. It's what you're used to.
I haven't played with it, so...
Yeah, it's what you get used to. Cool.
Thank you very much.
Ginger, yeah.
You got coronavirus or something?
Oh, with a bit of the coughing. Nah.
Bit of howie in you.
it's probably... I tend to do that after drinking, like milk. Hey?
Well, fine.
it's the milk and like a really, really strong coffee, sugary, and the porridge with the milk. You get that in the back of your throat.
Baggy.
Yeah. I bought there's a South Australian brewery, does all the boutique stouts.
Right.
I bought a butterscotch stout.
Is it nice?
I haven't tasted it, yeah.
Butterscotch?
So, butterscotch, yeah.
That sounds nice, man. It reduces a little bit to those fucking ice cream, man.
Maybe, yeah. So you're not comfortable with the salt and honey?
Nah.
No, if you cook just normal oats, if you look at the ingredients, it'll say a pinch of salt and sugar to taste.
Yeah,
well, nah. I've always done it.
Salted caramel shit, man, not a fan.
Oh, really? Nah. Oh, okay, I like it. I love it.
Not a fan at all.
We've done 2.3 km.
In about 45 minutes.
Thank you. time lap. Got a good snorkel on it. If you had one of these, there'd be some use.
Are they bullet holes in it? In the windscreen? Up top? Or are they just like someone smashed it?
Ah, oh, these probably dudes have come down and... Actually, well, from where I'm standing here, it looks like there's a bullet mark on the door. It's probably just, above the fuel tank. The fuel filler. The bullet holes there?
Nah, that's just someone's bashed it, man. Bullet holes, fucking, if it's gonna go in.
Bashed it with rot, what they?
Crowbar?
Very rounded.
Bullet, like a marking.
Actually, yeah, you're right, the bullet would take the paint off.
Yeah. You probably see the fucking bullet itself on the floor.
What actually is it?
It's an old
Rodeo,
isn't it? No, it's an old Buxton thing,
it's all about a tow bar.
It's
a bull bar on it, it's worth a couple hundred...
What's that?
Oh, the tow bar.
Yeah.
A couple hundred
bucks there.
Yeah, it's all on, mate. Oh, yeah? It doesn't look the best, though. Got a new improved suspension set up there by the looks of it.
Bush mechanic.
just have a gander out, just a 5-minute gander, oh, 2-minute gander. Not that I'm going to steal anything, I'm just curious. It's got the owner's manual in it, mate.
Won't sell it without it.
284,000 Ks. Baby. P-plater. Red Bull, Jim Beam, no. Macca's, Henry.
Someone's throwing the head unit.
Ah, okay.
Can
you play the bone? Yeah. Ah, sort of. Got an air filter over here, Ryko air filter.
Fuck, someone smashed that.
Yeah.
Fuck, you doing more like that.
Cool. Makes you wonder, like, let's
just come down and break it.
Yeah, it's like, seems like while we're here, let's get a rock and pulverise it or whatever, but why? But if you had one, I suppose, there's...
Yeah, take that for the copper.
Yeah, if you had one, it'd be... Yeah, spare parts and bits and pieces.
I've just been using it as a fuse box.
Unlucky.
There
you go, that's a good, perfectly good cap there. Hasn't broken. Yeah. That's a Sullivan gum trim, mate. Genuine ARB.
Glass included.
What's this thing? Some air. Air solenoid thing. Like a little air valve-y. Where's that go?
Is it pretty snorkel?
Air diff locker or something? Regulator, maybe? With your LED lighting. Keep you. It's ironic that when we first had our cars, like for me, old Mazda 1300, just break something, go to the wreckers, buy another one, break something, go to the wreckers.
Well, I'm still gonna make it, does it, man?
Diff, blow a diff, go to the wreckers, get another one. It's like $15 for a diff, but do it yourself.
Yeah, what the fuck is that, man?
What?
This thing, the box.
Could be a mine shaft. It's the main temple of Greenhill, a green car.
I think we fucking did the same thing last time, stopped over the car, never heard of it.
Very well, mine shaft around here. There's another hole in the back here. Well, normally the mine shaft, yeah, even around the back here, it's like it's been purposely stacked.
And like you can see more so around the front, like the mortar is shitting it.
Oh, okay.
So it's definitely man-made.
Could have been part of the old gold digging something or another. I don't know. Alright, we've probably done 2.4 kilometres now. You got no time constraints for getting back at fucking...
Oh, actually, Mrs. wants to be home at 4:15.
Oh, like the guy last was Jason's ride, yeah, he did that. He says, we did the loop and I said, oh, everyone right for time constraints? He goes, yeah, I gotta be back by blah blah blah. Like, fuck.
Back there.
Just like a pro.